Hey y'all, it's Farmer Meemaw, and today I want to share with you 8 ways that you can continue to celebrate big this holiday season when everybody's telling you you have to keep it small. If you're anything like me, you like to be a little extra on holidays, and so this year we're having to come up with some creative ways to fully embrace the holiday season and still kind of keep it small. And so I'm going to share with you these 8 things, and one of them is what I'm doing personally, and I'm so excited, and I will share with you at the end how exactly I'm doing that. Now, number 1 is a food exchange, and this just means basically that instead of having to cook all the dishes, you cook some and somebody else cooks some, and then you share. If you're in a situation where you can't have contact with other people, maybe they can drop theirs off on your front porch and you can leave yours out on your porch so they can pick it up and take with them. So that's number 1. Number 2, thanks to Zoom and FaceTime and things like that, we're able to celebrate with people who are far away and are not able to travel this holiday season because of all of the restrictions. And so maybe this year, in that empty seat, instead of a plate, you're going to have maybe a laptop on a Zoom call, and there's another laptop in another state sitting at an empty spot, and y'all can enjoy talking with each other around the table, kinda, this holiday season, just so that they can still be there and you can still celebrate together. You just need to maybe coordinate whenever everybody's gonna be eating at around the same time, and then you can still eat together. So that's number 2. Number 3. This is the one I'm doing, and that is celebrate all week. Now, we're used to having a huge celebration, lots of people, lots of food, but this year it's gonna be pretty small. And so, if you're like me, a lot of schools are out all week. We used to get Thursday and Friday out, and that was it. And then we used to get Wednesday and Thursday and Friday out, and that was it. Now the kids get out for the whole week. And so Monday, and we're actually not celebrating until Friday because of just family scheduling and such. And so Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, we are all having kind of a holiday themed. Now, it's not the same dishes, but it's other holiday dishes that we don't normally have. Maybe pumpkin dishes I'm planning on some holiday desserts during the week as well. And then on Thursday, it will be a little more traditional, but I think we're probably going to smoke a chicken it's just going to be the 4 of us on Thursday, me and my husband and my 2 youngest boys that are here at home. And so we'll probably smoke a chicken and have some kind of holiday-ish or our typical meals, but the big meal is going to be on Friday. And I have to keep in mind, on Thursday I'm probably going to be cooking a lot of those holiday meals or holiday dishes that we'll eat on Thursday. So I don't want to have anything too complicated. And one of those nights we're actually going to be having a Thanksgiving-themed brunch, but it's like breakfast for supper, but we're going to call it a brunch because it's cooler. So okay, that's number 3. Number 4, let's say you have usually celebrate with like 5 different families, but you have to keep it under a certain number of people. This year, maybe you celebrate with different people on different days. You know, maybe you celebrate with someone on Thursday and another family on Friday and another family on Saturday. And, you know, it may seem a little exhausting, but for those of us who love to be around other people and celebrate, we're okay with that. And it doesn't have to be a Thanksgiving meal every time. You might have like finger foods one time, or desserts during one get together, or breakfast during one get together. So you can celebrate differently without getting overwhelmed with the holiday dishes, you know. But you'll still be able to be around family that's not overwhelming and not going to get you in trouble. Okay, so number 5 already? Yes, number 5, a recipe share. Let's say you're not going to be able to exchange, like maybe normally your family from other states, they come and they bring their famous dishes, and that's not happening this year. And so maybe if some of them are willing to give up that secret recipe, you can have a recipe exchange, and they can share their recipes for those dishes that you love so much, but you're not going to be able to have because they're not coming. Do a recipe exchange. Or you may just do this with maybe the ladies in your church classroom or a group of friends or neighbors or something like that. And so a recipe exchange. That way you get to try new recipes, y'all. Okay, and now number 6. Let's say you're in a situation where you can't travel. And you know, maybe you're in a situation where you know your neighbors and get along with your neighbors. And maybe this year will be kind of, you know, they have Friendsgiving. Well, maybe this year is a Neighborsgiving. And you can exchange dishes. You can either get together and celebrate, if that's an option. Or you can exchange dishes with your neighbors. Or you can just deliver special treats to your neighbor. Maybe you want to give an apple pie or a pecan pie or a pumpkin pie or some cookies or something, and just share the holiday spirit with the people around you where you can go. Let's see here. And number 7, this is one we do a lot in the South, and you probably do it too where you're at, and that is fix plates. And that means if somebody can't be there, maybe they're, you know, they've had a positive test result and they're not able to get out of their house. Maybe you just fix them a plate and take it to them of your holiday setup, you know, dishes or whatever, so that they still get to enjoy that holiday meal, because there's probably a lot of people out there who either financially they're not able to celebrate the way that they would like to, or maybe they just can't. Maybe they don't feel well, they are not up to cooking, or can't get out to just even go shopping. And so just share the bounty and fix a plate and take it to them. And it could be multiple people. Maybe it's an older parent or grandparent or an older neighbor or just somebody from church who's not able to get out. Just take them a plate. And maybe they'll get a couple of people bringing them plates, and so they'll be set up for the weekend. And then lastly, and this kind of goes back to the baking holiday treats. And, you know, you don't have to wait for Christmas to do a cookie exchange. And so maybe a Thanksgiving themed cookie exchange, maybe some pumpkin spice cookies or whoopie pies or what else, some kind of cranberry oatmeal cookie or something like that. But doing a cookie exchange or cooking holiday treats and then delivering them to essential workers, maybe a plate of cookies to a firehouse or to a hospital, something like that might be a way to celebrate and let those essential workers know how thankful you are for them this holiday season. So let me know down below in the comments, what are some of the ideas that you've come up with as far as ways to get around this situation that we're in this year so that you can still celebrate, but celebrate differently? Because, you know, quick story. My husband, you know, when we first found out we were going to be celebrating on Friday, when we first found out that we weren't going to be able to celebrate Thursday evening, because that's kind of our normal time. We like to spend the day cooking because there's a lot to cook, y'all. We cook like, you know, 14 dishes and there's not even that many people, but we cook a lot because we're extra like that. And it takes a lot of time and it's a mad dash to get everything done on time. And so we usually like to do it in the evening. And this year that was going to be a time conflict. And so he originally expressed some frustration with that. And a little later, I, you know me, I'm just a little Pollyanna, and I'm just like, but I mean, it's not about the time as long as we celebrate. Because then I started thinking, okay, so how can we celebrate? Maybe we can celebrate Thursday morning and just do a brunch. because that way we would be able to have some Thanksgiving time eating Thanksgiving-ish things. And so we could do a brunch and, you know, and so my brain is like, or maybe we could celebrate on this day and that day and this day, you know. Anyway, because I want to celebrate. And it's really not any more expensive to celebrate Thanksgiving than most other times, other than how many dishes you have. Because let's face it, right now turkey is 77 cents a pound. 77 cents a pound for meat is not expensive. It's probably the cheapest meat you're going to get all year long, unless it's a hot dog, okay? And even that's not even a whole pound. So anyway, so if you shop wisely, it's not going to be more expensive to celebrate than any other time. And it might be in ways a little cheaper. So anyway, back to my husband. I was looking, you know, how Facebook stuff happens and people post about, you know, like how can I make my dollar stretch? I, you know, financially struggling. This is my life situation and I need help, you know, finding creative, cheap ways to celebrate Thanksgiving. And I was showing my husband this, you know, one of these posts on Facebook, and it was a family that had just gone through a whole lot of stuff, and now they're just trying to make ends meet and celebrate. And it was just like, I showed it to him and I was like, okay, now this is what they're going through. We're blessed. There's no reason for us to be grumpy or upset because we don't get to celebrate the time where we want to. And he was like, you're right. You know, it's like, we are so blessed. And so in this whole situation, when everything is so crazy, you can always find a reason you can always find something that you realize you're really truly blessed for. And so, it was just one of those moments, and he's like, yeah, okay. Sometimes you can be upset over something and then you can realize it doesn't matter. That's not the important part. And so on this holiday season, y'all, and then I was like, we can celebrate every day. And he was like, you can do whatever you want to do. But then he's like, but I'm not eating, because he does intermittent fasting. And so he eats in the morning and lunch, and then he doesn't eat supper. And then I was talking about cooking supper every day. And I'm like, and y'all, he's already like, he's like down to 200, like maybe a little more, not much. I'm just going to kick him to the curb. No, I'm not. He keeps losing weight. And I'm just like, you just shut up. I don't want him to keep losing weight. I don't want him to weigh less than me is the big thing. And he is so close right now. But anyway, he was like, and I was like, it is more important for me to get to nurture you and fix food for you to celebrate Thanksgiving than for you to be on that diet. and so he did say, he was like, okay, you can be in charge of the menu. And so I'm going to be cooking for him the week of Thanksgiving. And I'm really excited about that, because normally he cooks, and so, yeah, but he cooks the stuff. Like, when I cook, I want to try new things. And we have a child who does not like to try new things. And so he's always, or he used to be, whenever I would cook, he was like, he's not going to eat that. And I'm just like, don't say that. He might. So, anyway, I've gone off on a tangent, haven't I? So, anyway, the way that... Let me show you kind of a little bit about how we're celebrating. And we have our main thing, you know, on Friday. But like on Monday, I went through all the dishes that we're not going to have time, that I really like, but we don't have time to cook on the day we're celebrating Thanksgiving. I'm putting into these other days or things that I like, but maybe nobody else likes, and so it's not worth it. Like Brussels sprouts with bacon. Or, and I'm really liking the idea of being able to do desserts because I'm doing some, y'all know how I feel about clove, and I'm going to do some like an apple pie filling type thing with clove and cinnamon and some peaches with clove and maybe a peach cobbler or something in the crock pot with clove and cinnamon. Y'all know, oh, clove and cinnamon. Anyway, and so, and I went through and looked at Pinterest, of course, too, to find some new ideas. And of course, there's going to be pumpkin a lot because I've got a lot of pumpkin that I need to go through and eat and process and put in the freezer and all that good stuff. But like, we're going to have like pumpkin soup, and I'll have some keto dishes like my potato salad. We're probably not going to make on the day, but we'll probably do potato salad one day. And I will probably not be eating keto on those days. Not all of them anyway, because I do plan on enjoying myself this week and not worrying about it, because there's always next week or the next week, because next week is the week that we'll be fixing all these foods. So I'm rambling now. I love you guys, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye, y'all. Mwah.